Kalani, thank you for sharing. So powerful and so touching, so challenging, I think, and so brave. Yeah, I asked Kalani to share her story, and I knew it was going to be a vulnerable, hard thing, but I'm very proud of you, Kalani. Can we just want to once again affirm that? Kalani is a young woman that I've seen so much growth happen. We were kind of nearing the time for production, and there were a couple of issues around her having her surgery. But she, despite having the injury, we kind of rewrote the play and added that into the story just so that she could do it. And it was tough at times, you know, get to practice and stuff. But what I saw in you, Kalani, was you rising up through it all, through all the hard stuff. And I kind of reflect on Kalani's story. And I thought I would share with you, today being 360 Vision Cast Day, some of the things that I've learned while being part of 360. Today, I think I've been here at Pepsta for 2 years and 10 months. So I've been here for a while, and this is where I call home. And for me, 360, it really does mean a lot to me. All of you young people, I love you guys so much. I love the journey that we've been on the last 2 years and 10 months. I've loved seeing you guys grow. I've loved seeing you guys, you know, step out of your comfort zone. And I think when I was reflecting what to share on, I think this theme, rise up, keeps coming through. Rise up. I want to share with you guys two things that I've found help me in my journey and in my experience rise up. I think one of the things that I've learned from these young people is that rising up is possible. It's possible. I just want to pray, and then I'll get into the word. Lord, we just thank you so much for being an amazing God. We've sung it today. You're a God who wants to be our friend. And we thank you so much for that. We thank you so much for being a God who's mighty and powerful. And we just, in the next couple of moments, want to ask for your Spirit to fill us and to speak to us and do something in us so that when we leave here, we can leave changed and on fire and ablaze for you. We pray and ask all these things in your awesome name. And Pepsta said, amen, amen. Whenever I think of rise up, whenever I think of this idea of rise up, I always think of the story of my friend Ian. Now, I don't know if other speakers are like me where you think, have I shared this story before? And you're like, I don't know if I've shared this story before. If I have, I'm sorry, but I'm going to share it again. It's one of the stories that I think illustrate this idea of what it means to rise up. When I was in year 10, I was part of this thing called Project K, and I absolutely loved that experience. And for me, it helped me kind of push me past my comfort zone, and I get involved in stuff that I never would have if I wasn't part of that. But we were on a hike. And I absolutely love going on hikes. Anyone else here love going on hikes? Yep. We went to the Hunua Ranges. Anyone been to the Hunua Ranges before? Love that place. We went there and we kind of did this whole preparation time. They taught us how to pack. I'd never gone on a hike where I had to carry like a 20 kg bag, or, you know, it was so heavy. So they taught us how to pack that. They taught us how to dig our own toilets. They taught us all this stuff. And then we had a one-night stayover where we kind of were, we practiced how to camp and how to set up and all that. And then it came time for us to do the five-day hike. This five-day hike, we were going to go on this journey. And on the journey, they said that you would kind of navigate your way through the map, and wherever you choose to sleep, that's where you're going to sleep. There's no cabins, no nothing. You just set up your tent and you sleep, wake up, do the whole trek again. So for me, it was something I'd never done before, so I was really scared. But we did it. And day one, it was good. Day two, we kind of, we're enjoying it. We were having some awesome lessons, and we're learning things about nature, just learning different native trees and what they could do to help you if you had diarrhea or if you needed to have a shoelace. You know, this is what the plant that you do, and this is how you cook it, all that stuff. I've never had to use that before. But we came to the fourth day. And by the fourth day, now we're kind of tired and we're like, you know, sore bodies, everything. It had rained the night before. And so it was kind of like, oh, this is like the hard part of the trek. And the night before it was raining and all that. So it was quite slippery. And my mate, who was at the back of the pack, had been struggling for a while. And so as he's kind of pulling himself through the trek, it's quite muddy and it's quite hilly and it's quite steep. And we find ourselves on this part of the trek where he slips. And I remember hearing the thump on the ground. And I remember looking back and I remember seeing him kind of lift himself off the ground, and half his face had all this mud on it. And he was like, oh man, like, you know, if you've ever had mud on your face or your body before, it's not good. So he was like, oh, you know what, whatever, shakes it off, gets up. And he tries again. And 5 seconds later, hear him slap on the ground again. And so I look back and we all kind of, bro, you're right, are you right? And he's like, oh, yeah, I'm right, it's all good. I'm just, you know, got mud on my boots. He's trying to clean it off. Tries to go up again a third time and he hits the ground again. Now this happens 4 or 5 times, and it gets to the point where Ian is sitting on the ground, mud everywhere, and his spirit is defeated. His spirit is defeated. And we kind of do this thing where we surround him. All of the team gather around him, and one by one, everyone starts to say, Ian, you can do it. Ian, we believe in you. Ian, you can do it. And he's like, no, I can't. I want to go home. I'm tired. Just call my mom, get her. I can't do this anymore. And one by one, we encourage Ian. We say, Ian, don't worry. We got your back. We will lift you up. Someone was like, I'll take your bag for you. And so he took Ian's bag and he carried it on his back. And all of us are like trying to encourage Ian. And we stand there for about 15 minutes surrounding him, speaking identity into his life. And slowly Ian starts to get hopeful. Slowly Ian starts to get a bit of strength. Slowly Ian starts to get a bit of power, and he rises up and he finishes the track. Now he slipped again, but every time he slipped, we were there. We had his back and we brought him to the finish line. And there are two things that I want to share with you today, which I firmly believe with all my heart. If we're thinking about this thing of rising up, one of the most powerful things that you and I can do in our life is to surround ourselves with the right people. When I spoke a couple of months ago, I shared a story of one of the most difficult things that I had to do in my life up to this time. And it was different, and it was difficult for so many levels. But I was able to go through that situation because I was surrounded by good people. I was surrounded by my family. I was surrounded by the staff that were praying me up and were talking to me. And I was surrounded by people who, if they weren't there in the struggle and in the journey with me, I probably would not have done what I did. And the question is, who are you surrounding your life with? Who are the people that you're taking on the journey with you? You are able to rise up when you surround yourself with the right people. And the last kind of point that I want to share is we can rise up when we know who we are. There's a verse that I want us just to turn to, if you will. It's in Matthew chapter 4. If you want to join me, there's a couple of Bibles in the pews. We're just going to look at this one verse. And I think this is probably one of the important, and I've learned in my own life, when it comes to rising up, Matthew chapter 4. Matthew, the first book of the New Testament. The label there in my Bible is the temptation of Jesus. And if you're familiar with the story of Jesus, there's something that happens before this experience. And I actually want to read that first. John chapter 3, verse 16. John chapter 3, verse 16 says, after his baptism, as Jesus came up out of the water, the heavens were opened. The heavens were what, everyone? The heavens were opened. And he saw the Spirit of God descending like a dove and settling on him. And a voice from heaven said, this is my dearly loved son who brings me great joy. I want to suggest to you today that if we want to live a life of being able to rise up, you need to believe in who God says you are. Sometimes we think the gospel is opposite in that Jesus was born, Jesus lived his life, Jesus did all his miracles, he was crucified, he died, and he rose again, and then God said, this is my beloved son in whom I'm well pleased. But actually, when we look at the gospel story, it starts from a place where Jesus knows and believes who he is, and God declares over his life, this is my dearly loved son. This is my dearly loved son who brings me great joy. And out of this sense of identity, out of the sense of knowing who he was able to live amid the trial and the temptation and the accusation of the Pharisees. He lived his life from this space of knowing who he was. And I want to ask you the question today, do you know who you are? Do you know who you are? I want you to get this picture in your mind that regardless of the challenges and regardless of the journey, regardless of the hills and the valleys that you will find yourself in, God declares over your life today that you are his dearly loved child. You don't have to do something to reach that identity. That's who he says you are right now. You are his dearly loved child. And from that space, we can rise up. From that space, we can continue journeying. And from that space, we can live out God's purpose and God's identity in and through our lives. Just as I'm wrapping up, I'd love to invite our choir to come up. We sang this song in our production, and this song kind of speaks to this theme of rising up in a powerful way. I've learned so many things from being part of 360, and I've come to find that it's more than an age group that we have here at PEPSA. It's more than like this five-year gap that you're coming to camps and going to different things and part of production. What I've learned and what the power of 360 is, it's a culture. and it's a way of life. It's this thing where I've kind of understood it as full circle. And at 360, if you have ever been part of 360, we love to do things around circles. And it's this journey where you've come through, people have poured into your life, people have mentored you, and in your journey of high school years, you get this experience of journeying with people. But then when you leave, this culture is just so ingrained in you that you want to come back and you want to feel those who are coming after you. And if I want to share anything with you that will stick, is this idea that in your life and in my life, God gives us an opportunity each and every day to live our best life from knowing who we are and who surrounds us. And church, I want you to know that you are surrounded. You're surrounded, and that God declares over your life that He loves you and you are His child. I hope you're blessed by the song, Rise Up. Hey, can I encourage us as a church to just stand together as we finish off today? Awesome. Thank you. Father God, we just want to thank you so much for how our story is so deeply and powerfully impacted by your story. And we've heard today a powerful story from one of our young people who've shared. And we know that there are some people in our community, Lord, who are going through similar things. And Lord, all of us in some sense, in some way, are pushed down by the circumstances of our life. And so may we, in those moments, remember who we are in you, and to remember that we are surrounded, and that in that moment, may we choose to rise up. I pray a blessing over all of us as we move into this new week. And may in the moments where we rise up, may that inspire someone around us to do the same. So we thank you for being an awesome God. We thank you for loving us. We thank you for the opportunity that we get to be part of this whole story of what you do in this world. We thank you so much, and we pray all these things in the powerful name that is above every name. And all of Pabst said, amen.